Good morning, gentlemen. This is the second share of Shemirat Halashon, Think Before You Speak series. Lilu Nishmat, the great Hafetz Haim, and also for the Yeshua and the Hatzlacha for our entire Chabur of guys, and specifically for Chaim Davidov and Chayisara, Shem Shesender, a Yeshua, Bekarov, with Shemirah Me'al Yemen HaShamayim. Today's Halacha, I would call the Yenta, which is an interesting halacha. You know, on every block amongst neighbors, there's always that one neighbor. The one that knows everybody's business, and boy, do they have this drive to share their information with everyone on the block, from what's coming in and what's going out, chas v'shalom, from the dirt on people, and the details of people's lives that not everybody really wants to share. Sometimes in yeshiva, you have that guy in the back room in the coffee room who knows exactly who's getting kicked out of yeshiva, who's getting engaged, whose engagements are breaking any day, and so on. These people know everything about everyone, and they love to share the information in spite of the fact that it is information that's clear and absolute gossip. This person is called the Baal Lashon Hara. The end. The Baal Lashon Hara. A person who habitually speaks Lashon Hara constantly is considered a Baal Lashon Hara. And their punishment is far, far worse than typically someone who every now and then slips up by speaking what they shouldn't. This Baal Lashon Hara, he's in a category of his own. It's on him that the Hafetz Haim would always mention the famous Rambam. The Rambam says that when someone speaks Lashon Hara, he's over tantamount to the Gimel Averot Chamurot. Could you imagine that? He speaks Lashon Hara, it's like murder, it's like adultery, it's like idol worship. Says the Hafetz Haim, yes, that is referring only to a Baal Lashon Hara, someone who speaks Lashon Hara habitually, constantly. Them, they make no effort to restrain themselves from what they shouldn't say. They're real gossipers, and their mouth is completely hefker. These people suffer in this world, and they lose their portion in Olam Haba. Unbelievable. How do we break out of this category of people? These people, the Baal Lashon Hara, they're in a category of their own. How do we break out of this category of people? Says the Hafetz Haim, by learning the laws of Shmirat HaLashon, you're making a conscious effort that these halachot mean something to you. That already takes you out of the category that you are not considered halachically a Baal Lashon Hara. And now, even if the guy slips up every now and then, and he does say every now and then something he shouldn't, but a Baal Lashon Hara, he's not. This is the great importance and the obligation to learn Shemirat HaLashon every single day. It serves as an awareness to think before you talk, but it also stands as a testimony on me and you. It's our badge that we wear. I am not a Baal Lashon Hara. Thank you.